Welcome again, fellow disciples of the Zettel. This is the next episode about to start being recorded, and it's about peak. No, it isn't. That's the wrong book. And it's about Range by David Epstein, as always. I am finally nearing the 100 pages mark. And today we are going to look at chapter 5, Thinking Outside Experience. Does not yet ring a bell. I have to flip forward a bit here. Ah, I got some summaries. To have creative ideas and solve your domain's problems, to know things outside of it helps. Aha. Okay, so in case you want to become a domain expert, you also have to have non-domain specific knowledge. Knowing more and knowing more varied things is important. I think that is the hypothesis of chapter 5. And chapter 5 is going to be 22 pages long. And I do have 1, 2, does it count? It just says WTF. Let's say 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 little dashes in the margin of my book. Let me have a quick look at the Emacs org mode file to see if I want to tell you about something from last episode, because I think I had some interesting things going on. I did fix the node visualizer script, so this time it will be useful after all. And I also... No, I didn't complete any of the to-dos. So I will not start the video stream. No, not the video stream, the video recording with an overview of the to-dos, because I haven't tackled any of them. And there's still research to-dos. I think this chapter, because I have a feeling, a vague feeling, I don't really remember, but I have a vague feeling that this is going to be important chapter, and that I'm going to end up with a lot of other research to-dos for my future self. Maybe next or the episode or the episode after that, I have to tackle these. I don't want to, you know, blend it in, the to-do solving and the actual book processing, even though they're one of the same in practice. It would slow me down so much that I wouldn't be able to finish a chapter. So I'd rather finish the chapter today and then spend a whole episode catching up with leftovers. Hope that makes sense. That's the plan, at least. Let's see what we got. Mr. Epstein was very kind so far with surprises like references and citations that didn't actually occur in the full text anymore. But well, more citations is better than what he did the episode prior, which was not citing very much, you know? So let's get on with it. It's time to process this book. See you on the other side. And this is it. It is the part where I'm processing the summary that I prepared while I read the book. This chapter is not very long, and this episode is not going to be very long either, because there won't be so many things I've actually found interesting. This is the actual summary. It's three things: an anecdote, a reference for later, and experts falling to apply their knowledge outside their fields, which reminds us all about domain-limited knowledge, doesn't it? Since it's Halloween soon, I prepared a few jump scares in this video. I'm still getting out a few quotes here and there from Epstein, and sort them under their respective parts in the outline that I'm working on here. And this is the actual outline with a focus on the curriculum anecdote by Kahneman that Epstein is also referring to. We're going to get back to this later, and I'm actually going to create a to-do entry way later in this episode when I find that Kahneman is saying much more interesting things, as far as I'm concerned. Here I'm looking for a fallacy on the internet because I remembered that this has a name, this outside view, inside view dichotomy that we're going to look at, or that I'm going to look at maybe in the next episode when I work on Kahneman. Here you see me opening a new tab in the archive because I find this to search for a reference and then put it in there where I was working on earlier. To be much more convenient than working with the double Q trick where you leave a finger between the pages of the virtual notebook, so to speak. Look at the Zettelkasten homepage to get more info about the QQ trick. And this here is the focus that I'm going to next. It's about problem solving, where I think of computational thinking and determining structures, and it's a reference to a paper by Chi and others that Epstein makes, and I have a hard time finding the full text available, so it's probably not open access or anything, and I have to go to the library later. Took me some time, but here, what's this? I'm going to click on this link and then create a note from this part of the outline, of course. Copy pasting a few sections from the book and my pasteboard, which has historic items, which means I can prepare or can copy like 10 things right away and then paste 10 times later to get all the things I copied earlier back, which is super handy for extractions of notes like this. I didn't have the full text for Chi, Feltovich, Glaser and the others, so I'm putting up a to-do in my to-do list for later. And this is the final note, the Chi note, with Epstein citations and a bit of rephrasing of the abstract, but I can't say more because I haven't read the paper. So this is a placeholder, if you will. And do I know if placeholders are a good idea? Not yet. Well, this is before I reduce the notes here to a much shorter form, by copy-pasting, cutting here and there, and then reformatting things. This is the outline as I will leave it at this moment. I move things over, rephrase them in the Chi note. And there you go. That's the pasted-in version after all the back and forth. And with that, we are already finishing the first 45 minutes of work. In this break, I prepared food on my stove and figured that I should probably set a timer for later. And this is my great command line interface timer that will remind me later during the process so I can put the next thing on the stove. You see me looking for the Kahneman things that I thought I had but actually didn't. Looking for the things on Kahneman's thinking fast and slow. Yes, thinking fast and slow here, and I'm just figuring out. Yeah, you know, this is an old note. It's I didn't translate it to English at this point, but it's an old note with an old header, so I might as well clean things up, like good Boy Scouts do. You know, you encounter something that's outdated, then you clean it up and make it better. I'm also pasting in the interesting pieces that I find into my project buffer outlines, if you will, for independent software development, where the outside view will be important later as well. Et voilà. This is the link. Irrational preservance sunk costs and ignoring the data at hand is my rephrasing of the inside view and outside view dichotomy, and how you should collect experience, yes, but not rely on the data that you get. And on the table, you actually see that I am working with the Kahneman book, Thinking Fast and Slow, directly, looking things up and preparing citations for later. And actually, I'm citing Kahneman here and there, now that the book is already open. I'm citing Kahneman here and there, and I'm going to do more of this in another episode, I think. And here I have the inside view and outside view, and how the estimates are bad, not prepared. And here's the note as it's going to look like way later, once I extracted what you will see now, which is the anecdotes, the curriculum story that Epstein uses with proper citations from Kahneman or to Kahneman's book, and also the reference to Epstein and a web link. So if I find the story interesting, want to share it with others, I have a handy web link to copy and paste into emails and whatnot. Hope this will be useful. Who knows? We will see later, maybe years from now. And the same as before, I'm pasting the inside and outside view estimate note link into another buffer note, another structure outline, whatever you want to call it, where it's about the crafting part of independent software development. And I think project estimates fit very well. And I enjoyed this so much that I decided to put this into my to-do list as well, to process the Kahneman book. And here you are. Have a look at my food as I prepared it. Isn't it tasty? It has so many tasty parts, and yet it's too hot to eat. Still too hot. So I'm leaving it where it is. But it will be munched later. So tasty. So, inside view, outside view. Here's a link from the Epstein structure note to the detail. I'm looking for more things to extract. Moving notes around and pieces. And here is another story that I think is kind of related to what we had before. So I'm clicking through, following some links, pasting in the story, and there you go. Pasted it in, bam. Proper formatting, and there's the story from Epstein as another anecdote. I hope this separation of anecdotes and studies and monographies pays off, because the stories are easy to share, but ultimately are useless for real work. Also related, another reference that Epstein makes is a Van Boven paper about the unpacking effect. I'm curious to see what this is going to be. I haven't read it yet. But it's about the same notion that the more you know, the less useful your judgment will become, which is paradoxical, and such is of high interest to me and my Zettelkasten. Probably guessed what's coming next. I'm going to extract this to refactor the nested outline into a web of links to new notes. And there you go. Sure enough, I have pasted things in, looking for stuff on my pasteboard, history, clipboard history. And this is again something I didn't process. Details make your judgment worse. That's the Van Boven to-do. And it's another placeholder. There's just two Epstein citations and a reference to the Van Boven paper itself, in case I look for it. But this wasn't super useful. You know, this session, I'll be honest, I didn't have that much time. Another cut is going to happen here. I didn't have that much time this day, and it was pretty late already. So I decided to defer doing all the details until later. I certainly didn't have the time to dig into two papers right now at that point. There's no clock in the corner, but it's pretty late. Not that late. It's not getting dark, as you see, because otherwise my dark note would have kicked in again. But there, I moved another stuff over, and I'm going to show you This is the final note, and I'm going to show you the visualization of the web of nodes as it is in relation to the Epstein node. This is the new part about the inside view and outside view, and here you see how some things have moved over a bit. It's part of the visualizations algorithm, but it looks more interesting already, doesn't it? This new thing is like a proper appendix and not just very, very shallow first order link. And yeah, that was it already. I want to thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed some of the links that I added and some of the references that I found. I sure think this is going to be interesting to dig them up, which I will do. And I'm still deciding and making up my mind if I should do this in the next episode or the episode afterwards and collect some more to-dos. But the placeholders have to eventually be replaced with proper content, you know? Otherwise, I would do bad science and very useless knowledge work, which certainly is not my goal. If you have questions, leave them in the forums, ask stuff. I'm very, very happy to receive feedback on the format and on the book and on the whole process that you're watching. So, hope to be hearing from you. Again, thank you for watching, and I hope you have a great rest of your day.